Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, we are going to look at the Acer Aspire 5 Slim Series laptop. So this laptop is the best-selling laptop on Amazon right now. And in today's video, I want to actually look at two different configurations of this laptop. So the first one is the AMD Ryzen configuration, and this laptop sells for about $315. And the second configuration is the Intel configuration. So Intel has a bunch of different configurations, but the one that I want to talk about today is the Core i3 configuration, and that one goes for about $360. So we will go over both these configurations of the laptop, their performance, synthetic benchmarks, real life usage, and at the end of the video, I will give you my opinion on which laptop I think is a better value for money. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay, so before we get into the differences between the AMD configuration of this laptop and the Intel configuration, let's first go over the common things which both these laptops share. So the chassis for both these laptops is exactly identical. So whether you buy an Intel version for $360 or whether you get the AMD version, this is the AMD version for $315, you will get exact same chassis. And I'm very happy with the build quality of this laptop. So the lid, the top of the laptop is aluminium and it has this brushed metal finish. It looks really very nice. It actually makes the laptop look premium than the price that you are paying. And the back of the laptop is polycarbonate or plastic in simple English. And I like the feel of the laptop. It feels very solid, feels very sturdy. There is no, creak or, it's not like bending or anything. And overall, I think this is a very good build quality. And the other thing which I love about this laptop is that it's really light. So this is really nice because even though it's a 15.6 inch screen, the laptop is so light, you can easily put it in your backpack and you can carry it with you. So if you are a student or if you are somebody who travels a lot with the laptop, I think you will be very happy with the, the design, the weight and overall look and feel of the laptop. So one other thing which I like about this laptop is that when you put it on the table and when you open it, it opens smoothly with one hand. So it's perfectly balanced. A lot of the laptops in the cheaper category, when you try to open them, they tilt. Okay, moving on to the screen of the laptop. This is a 15.6 inch screen. The screen is full HD. That means it's 1920 by 1080p resolution and it's backlit LED display. So for this price, I am very impressed with the quality of the LCD panel. It is a IPS display, so the viewing angles are actually pretty good. It has some kind of an anti-glare coating. It doesn't reflect a lot. And also the brightness of the screen, it's over 200 nits, which is perfect for indoor use. So even if you have a very bright lit classroom or indoor office or anything like that, you will not have any trouble using this laptop. So one more thing that I like about the screen of this laptop is that the bezels are very minimal, especially on the sides. The left and right hand side of the laptop has very minimal bezels. The top and bottom bezels are a little bigger, but again, for a laptop in $300 price category, this is very impressive. Okay, the next thing which I want to talk about is the keyboard. So in my opinion, the keyboard and the trackpad, those are the two very important features of any laptop, and this is something where the budget laptops tend to cut corners. So what Acer has done is very nice, and honestly, I have not seen this good quality keyboard in a $300-$350 laptop anywhere. So this is a backlit keyboard and it's really nice. The pressure which the keys exert is almost, I find it very comfortable because it's not mushy keyboard. And as far as the trackpad is concerned, trackpad is made of plastic. It's not like a glass trackpad, but I felt that the trackpad was very responsive. It comes with the Windows 10 precision drivers, which means your multi-finger gestures are supported. And so two finger, three fingers, scrolling and all those things work very nicely. Okay, so these were the common things between the two flavors of the laptop that we were talking about. Now let's get to the meat of this video, which is basically the difference between the Intel configuration and the AMD configuration. So this laptop right here is the AMD configuration. This is the AMD Ryzen processor and the Vega 3 graphics. Specifically, it's the AMD Ryzen 3 3200U processor, whereas the Intel configuration will come with an Intel Core i3 8130U processor. So when we look at these two processors, the interesting thing is that these two processors are actually very close to each other in terms of the specs. Both of them, the base frequency is very close. AMD is running at a little higher base frequency of 2.6 gigahertz, and the turbo frequency, which is the maximum frequency that the CPU will overclock itself, that is 3.5 gigahertz for AMD, whereas Intel is 3.4 gigahertz. Both these processors, they are 2-core, 4-thread, and both of them have 4 MB cache. So when you look at the specs, they look very identical, but what about the performance? So let's look at some synthetic benchmarks to figure out which processor performs better than the other. So the first synthetic benchmark that we are going to look is called Cinebench R15. This is a single core specific benchmark, so it's not going to target multi-core or hyper-threading. Now the performance here is almost neck to neck, 2% is almost within margin of error. Okay, moving on to the next synthetic benchmark. This is the multi-thread benchmark, and it's again the Cinebench R15, but instead of looking at one core, this one is going to take a look at the multi-core and also take into account the hyper-threading. Both these processors are neck to neck. In fact, their performance is almost identical. Okay, so moving on to another synthetic benchmark. This is the Geekbench 3 benchmark. So first we will look at the single core performance. So the Geekbench benchmark also uses the system memory performance of the platform. So in this configuration, interestingly, Intel pulls ahead and it scores 3600 points as opposed to the Ryzen, which scores 3045. So that's a 15% performance boost for Intel. And we see something similar in the multi-core synthetic test for the same Geekbench. And as you can see here, the Intel is scoring 7070 points as opposed to Ryzen's 5960. So that's a 16% performance boost. So in the Geekbench test for both single thread and multi-thread testing, it's clear that Intel is about 15% faster than AMD. But the million-dollar question is that does that make a difference in the real life usage? The synthetic benchmarks, you should not fully rely on these benchmarks when making your purchasing decision. Based on my personal experience playing with both the flavors of this laptop, I will say that I did not really feel any difference. So the performance, in my opinion, and this is very subjective, but I think that both the processors are completely neck to neck. If we compare the graphics performance between these two configurations, the Intel configuration comes with Ultra HD graphics 620, whereas the AMD comes with a Vega 3 graphics. And on this synthetic benchmark, the Intel graphics is about 25% faster than AMD Vega 3. But I will repeat what I just said, which is that, you know, in real life experience, when I was streaming Netflix 4K content, when I was playing YouTube 4K videos, and also when I played Fortnite and some of the other simple casual games, I did not see any difference between the Intel and the AMD graphics. So it all boils down to price. And since the Intel laptop is selling for about $360, whereas the Ryzen configuration, the AMD configuration, is going for about $315, I think it makes more sense that you save your money and go with the AMD configuration. So the first bottleneck when it comes to performance is actually not Intel or AMD, it's actually Microsoft. The problem with both these laptops is that they are running something called Windows 10 S mode, and S mode is basically shit mode. And the reason I call it shit mode is because it is a highly crippled version of Windows 10, and it puts artificial constraints on the user. So the first constraint is that you can only install software which is present in the Windows App Store, and there is hardly anything on Windows App Store. Windows App Store has been like a, you know, barren land. So take the example of a browser, right? If your favorite browser is Google Chrome browser or Mozilla Firefox browser, then you are out of luck, because these browsers are not available on Microsoft App Store, and you will not be able to run those, you know, browsers on this laptop. So that's the biggest problem with Windows S mode. So luckily there is a very simple fix for this. You can exit Windows S mode, and it's completely free. You will not have to pay anything to do that. So in order to exit Windows S mode, you have to go to Windows Start button and then go to the settings. From there, click on Update and Security, and then click on Activation. So now you will see the current version of Windows that your laptop is using now, and it will report it as Windows 10 Home in S mode. So what you want to do is to get rid of this shit mode, and in order to do that, you click on the Go to Store. So when you do that, Windows App Store will launch and you will see an option to switch out of S mode. So now what you need to do is click on the blue Get button, and then click on Install. And that's it. That's all you need to do. So Windows will exit the S mode and it will basically upgrade your laptop to Windows 10 Home Edition. Now the second bottleneck with both the configurations, the Intel and the AMD version, is the system RAM. Both these configurations come with only 4 GB of system memory, and 4 GB of system RAM is not going to cut it for you. In 2019, if you want to run your Windows operating system smoothly and you want to install apps and do the basic things that you do on your computer, you will struggle with 4 GB of system RAM. So your laptop will have about 12 screws on the back of the laptop. So you need a Phillips head screwdriver and go ahead and remove all these screws. And once you have got rid of all the screws, then you need to pry open the back of the laptop. And so you can use anything soft. So you can use either, you know, a used plastic credit card or maybe a knife, a plastic knife, and gently pry open the back of the laptop. Once the back of the laptop comes out, you will have access to the system memory. So as you can see here, I opened the back of my laptop and you will see two memory slots. One memory slot is already occupied with the 4 GB of memory stick and the other one is empty. So at this point, you have multiple options. One option is that you upgrade to 16 GB of memory, and you can do that by purchasing 2 8 GB memory sticks and you know, putting the new sticks in the two slots. You will have to get rid of the older memory. Now if you are on a tight budget, then you can buy either a 8 GB of memory stick or a 4 GB of memory stick, and you can pair it with the existing memory in your computer. So I will throw a link in the description of the compatible memory modules which you can buy from Amazon. I have tested all these memory modules and they work both with the Intel or the AMD version. So if you want the best performance, then my recommendation is that you should get the 16 GB memory kit. If you are on a budget, then you buy either the 8 GB memory stick or the 4 GB memory stick. And when you pair it with the existing 4 GB of memory, you will end up with either a 12 GB or a 8 GB of, you know, memory in your system, which is still good enough and you will have much better performance. One other optional upgrade that you can perform is increase the total storage of the laptop. So both these configuration, AMD and Intel, both of them come with only 128 GB of storage. So as you can see here in the laptop, there are two SSD slots. One is a M.2 slot, which is already occupied with 128 GB of SSD. And the other is a empty slot. This is a SATA 3 2.5-inch slot where you can, you know, put additional SSD. So if you replace the existing 128 GB of SSD with a new M.2 SSD, you will have to clone the operating system. The other option is that you don't mess with the existing M.2 SSD and just buy a 2.5-inch SATA 3 SSD. So that way you can, you know, increase the storage using the second SSD slot and you can keep your existing 128 GB SSD. So I will recommend this upgrade to anybody who wants to use their laptop for multimedia, you know, like say video editing, you have a DSLR camera, or if you have a video camera and you want to record videos, then you will need more storage and 128 GB is not going to cut it. So this is an optional thing. And if you are interested, check out the links below. I have links to both the M.2 SSD and also the SATA SSD. Okay, so with these upgrades, you are going to get a very good performance from your laptop. So in my case, I have an AMD Ryzen configuration. And what I did was I added 16 GB of system RAM. And I added extra SSDs to increase the storage. And after doing those two upgrades, I'm very happy with the performance that my laptop is giving me. And I'm actually doing some heavy lifting on this laptop. I have done 4K video editing. I run Photoshop. I have done some programming intense applications which require a lot of CPU cycles and also memory. Anything that I've thrown at this laptop, it has handled it with ease. So I'm very impressed with the performance. So to summarize, here is what I will say. It doesn't matter whether you go with the Intel version or the AMD version, both give the same performance. So it's really up to you. If you want to save some money, go with the AMD version because it's around $315. And if you are more comfortable buying an Intel product, then go with the, you know, $360 version. But the real performance boost will come when you upgrade the system RAM and when you exit the Windows 10 shit mode, right? The S mode. So that will not cost you anything. The exiting the S mode is free. System RAM is obviously going to cost you some money, so based on your budget, you can pick one of the three options that I have given you. And like I mentioned, I'm throwing all the links in the description. Check out the prices and see what makes sense for your case. Okay guys, so that's it for today. I hope you found this video useful. If you have any question or concern, please drop a question in the comment section below and I will try to help you guys. If you like this video, then please like this video and subscribe to my channel if you want to see more content like this. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.